originally was really scary to me. It's the largest continuous wilderness in lower 48. And so to prepare, our llamas spend 4 months getting in shape. We spend at least that long getting ourselves in shape. We spend countless hours talking to biologists and looking at the slopes and angles and things like that, where the good vegetation is going to be on the mountainside. We look at a lot of Google Earth, lots of maps. We try to do 2 to 3 scouting trips prior to the hunt if we can. And so there's a lot of money and fuel and a lot of preparation, a lot of gear. You know, and your gear's gotta work, it's gotta last. It snows in July in the Frank Church. Kyle came in here last year, or this year, to scout for us. And the rest of us were all working, couldn't get off. And Kyle bit the bullet, came in, and snowed on him in July. Having the right gear, knowing where you're going, what you're trying to accomplish, being the elevation, hunting the elevations that animals like to reside, and that is kind of how we prepare. I've been doing this, my family's been, you know, guiding and outfitting and hunting for part of our living for 4 generations. You know, I went on my first elk hunt at 8 years old, and it was a thoroughfare, big backcountry horse, you know, pack in. And it's just been a part of who I am. And to kind of keep the legacy of my family alive, I hunt. You know, that's a big part of it. It's where I find a lot of peace, you know, and solitude in my life. Kind of, I get to regroup when I'm up here, hiking and hunting wild country. I don't see people hunting animals like the natives hunted them years and years ago, where Lewis and Clark hunted them years and years ago. It is a feeling that gives you goosebumps. Up here, and hunting is who we are. You know, we have canine teeth for a reason. We're meat eaters. To try to outsmart a mature elk, bull elk, or a matured mule deer at the end of a hunt, if you were succeeded, is a great feeling of accomplishment, you know. I really like sports, was an athlete in high school, a little bit in college, and to be able to come up here and have a level of competitiveness when hunting elk and deer is pretty exciting. Hunting has always had a big role in conservation. The day that we get our rifles taken away from us, or our bows taken away from us, and the day that we can't hunt elk and deer anymore, or wolves and bears and mountain lions, we're going to have major problems, you know. And we call it the Frank Church combo, a 6-point bull elk and a 4-point mule deer. If you can come in here and do that every year, it's extremely rewarding and very hard to accomplish.
Close to the ones that are fighting, just to the right. Here he comes. Just came out. Don't move, I got him. Don't move. As soon as he gives me a shot, I'm going to shoot him. Is that okay with everybody? Jeremy?
Yep, you're good.
Watch my shot, the wind's blowing pretty hard.
Got him.
Is it going down?
Yeah.
Go ahead, whack one, Jeremy. There we go. Then you shoot him again?
I can't see him, I lost
him.
You
shoot him again.
He's just standing there, I think.
He's riding right in the back.
He's down.
Yours is?